Hello everyone, this is Katie Colleen here. Welcome back, Colleen Clan, or if you are new, then come join the family. Today we are making a anime alien boy cosplay. You know, in true Colleen fashion, it's for a collab. Y'all know I love my collabs, I love my cosplay groups, I love the group photos, and a lot of times I don't even think about it. I'll just see a collab like, oh, we need this person, and I'm like, yeah, I could make that in a few weeks, I'll be there, like, I got you. And that's exactly what happened here. So I will be part of a Tokyo Mew Mew collab, which I'm really excited about. I have a lot of nostalgia for Tokyo Mew Mew, the new anime is coming out. So I will be making Kishu, or I think he's also called Kish in some of the translations. So not a character I would normally like gravitate to and do, but also like I love collabs and I just want to be a part of this. And like, honestly, Kishu is, I was gonna say a sweet boy, but he's really not. Anyways, I think I've talked enough. We're gonna make this whole Kishu cosplay from scratch in 2 weeks. So let's look at the patterns and materials. Patterns. For the undershirt for Kishu, I'm using this like Halloween pattern. I use this for my Lucille cosplay too. For the shorts, I have my leggings pattern, which I'll just alter and we'll make that work. And then for his like overshirt and his little skirt thing and his boots, I'll just pattern those out myself. Materials. So for the like undershirt and undershorts, I have my Yayahan Cosplay Fabrics 4-Way Matte Stretch in black and the same thing in red. I have not yet bought the stuff for the rest of the costume. We're in that part of Con Crunch, guys, where I'm like starting on the costume before I've even bought everything. Oh my gosh. I'm just gonna get started on the undershirt and shorts as much as I can, and then we will check back in to look at the rest of the materials. So starting with our undershirt, I am going to have this completely lined like basically every other project I make. So that means I'll be cutting it out twice. And I'm pretty much just going to be using our pattern as is. The only difference I need to make is I just need to make it shorter, which is a really quick fix. The only kind of difficult part here is putting our poofy sleeve in. So I'm gathering this sleeve using the gathering stitch on my sewing machine. This is just a really, really long straight stitch. And then these stitches kind of act as like a thread that the fabric can kind of scrunch along. The fabric just kind of moves along these gathering stitches. And once I get the sleeve to the same size as the sleeve hole, I just zigzag stitch that sleeve in. So I actually went ahead and sewed both the outside layer and the lining layer of the top. This goes really quickly and it kind of made more sense to just make both of them and try them on together. It's gonna look better when I get the bottom of the sleeve all scrunched up. It's gonna look better, I promise. Right now it just like, I'm going to start out by attaching the collar. I'm gonna need the collar. So I'm gonna be cutting out some 2-inch wide red bias tape strips from my red cosplay fabrics. And that's gonna be attached to all those edges. Now I will have to do a bit more gathering for the bottom of the sleeve too. And this is really the same story as I did with the shoulder seam. There we go. It looks so much better when it's actually like properly gathered and the sleeves are finished. This looks so much better than it did before. I had a big brain moment where I realized that I kind of need to have the brown overshirt to know how short I need to make this black part, because the black definitely doesn't show beneath the brown overshirt thing. So I'm gonna want that to decide how to finish this. I'm gonna move on to making the undershorts, and then we can get into some of our other fabrics and other pieces of this build, but I'd like to get like the base finished. So I made a Batgirl cosplay and that was from the leggings pattern, and it seemed easier to just alter that pattern than go back to the original leggings pattern. And basically I'm just gonna cut it out like really, really wide. So with the bicep measurement on the top, it was twice the size of my bicep and I had to ruffle it down. So with the thigh measurement on the shorts, I'm gonna do the same thing. So there's about the same amount of ruffle on the top and the shorts. So I'm also gonna do that for the waist too. So the waist is also gonna be like huge, which I'm then going to ruffle down later. The thing with the shorts, I think it looks fine, except they're a little bit too low-waisted now. So looking at the pattern I made for my Batgirl, those went like all the way up to here. Those were way too high-waisted. So I kind of like folded the top of the pattern over and I was like, I'll make these a little bit shorter. I apparently went a bit too intense on that. And now the shorts don't quite cover my butt, which is a problem. And there are a few things I can do at this point. Obviously, it's like too late in the game to restart, right? That they're like done, basically. So I'm thinking if I have like a big, like 3-inch waistband, then this will fit over my butt. As much as I would like to try out this method and see if it works, I actually can't finish either of these pieces until I've done the brown overshirt and overskirt kind of layers. I have this like faux suede. This was actually with the upholstery fabrics, like what you use to put on chairs. The other fabric I picked up is this Cosplay Fabrics burgundy. This is actually really, really cool. It's like kind of metallic. And I'm gonna be using this for the arm wraps and the leg wraps. But I think I'll just do the little skirt piece right now. It's literally just a rectangle. I'm gonna have this be lined because I do that with everything, but bam, like our overskirt thing's done and we can start looking up throwing that in the waistband and seeing if the shorts are going to fit over my butt or not. You can see the waistband's a little funky, but like they actually very much surprisingly fit. Man, the shorts were so frustrating. There were multiple times making these pants that I was about ready to toss it all out. I don't know what I was supposed to do, but like it was so frustrating because you truly cannot try on these pants until they are basically 100% done. You just can't really try it on until all of the gathers are sewn into place with the waistband. And you see, we had this challenge where we were going to make a costume in basically 2 weeks from scratch, and I've just decided to take this challenge and do it on hard mode. For you guys that have been following the car crash saga from the car crash I got into on the way up to SoccerCon, after all the phone calls and paperwork and estimates, my insurance company called me and they're like, look, we're totaling your truck. So you could turn your truck in and we'll give you money, but we ain't gonna fix it. I don't own a vehicle right now, so that means this weekend I'm going to be trying to purchase a vehicle on top of finishing the bulk of my Kishu cosplay. It was actually so stressful that during the week I decided I needed a break from sewing and I worked on Kishu's props. The order that I generally make my costumes is the most significant pieces first, and then the things you can go without last. Like, I definitely could have done this collab without weapons at all, and it still would have gone okay. But I was just so stressed from all the car stuff and not being able to leave my house, and the car that got totaled was the one that actually fit my wheelchair comfortably in it. So, like, it's been stressful, y'all. So these are Sai. And I bought these off of Amazon. They're made of rubber, so they're like clearly fake. These are done and out of the way. But even though it's still a little stressful over here, we gotta get Kishu done. So next, I will be moving on to doing a mock-up for his top thing. Now for this mock-up, I'm starting out with the same pattern I used for the undershirt, and I'm just cutting out the front and back pieces. So looking at this overshirt, it looks deceptively simple. It looks like it should come together pretty quick, but when you look at how it is shaped, it can be a bit difficult. It's really fitted on the shoulders, and then it's really flowy at the bottom of this top. So that means I'm probably gonna have to put a dart in here or mess around with it a little. And once I have a working mock-up, then I can tear this all apart and cut it out in our actual fabric. And once this is cut out into the faux suede, it goes pretty quickly. So I'll have to do the darts first, but after that, it's literally just shoulder seams and side seams. And that's our top. So I still do not have a car. That didn't go super well, but look at this, huh? I do not think that this fabric was really the absolute best option for Kishu, but I think it was the best option from my choices that I had. This is why you don't just start and finish cosplay projects in 2 weeks, okay? At this point, I'm trying not to be too picky, you get me? So I think that this is good enough, and I'm gonna do this again for the outside layer, and I think from there we just attach the two layers together. I didn't feel like squeezing this onto Gertrude or myself, so you get the top modeled on a clothes hanger. The zipper install was rough. This is the ugliest zipper install I have done in a while, but it is mostly just covered by this overshirt, so it's not a problem. And with that, the costume is wearable. I have a shirt, I have pants. Next, I would like to make the arm wraps and the leg wraps. Making these wraps isn't really difficult, it's just really, really tedious. So I cut out a base piece. I've done a lot of different like forearm cuffs and bracers and stuff, so I just took an old pattern and altered that. And then you cut out a bajillion bias strips. I went with 2-inch bias strips. And I laid those on top in kind of a like overlapping pattern. After that's all done, I top stitched both sides of every one of these bias tape strips. So I just folded over the edges and top stitched it down. And then I just sewed the back seam and I have my little forearm pieces. I also lined them as well, just because. Let's keep with the theme of lining everything I make for this build. So here they are, and it took me, I'd say, like about an hour each, an hour and a half for each one, and I still have to make the leg wraps, and the leg wraps are even bigger. Like, oh no, I'm still a few hours out from finishing. So I will be chugging away on the leg wraps. It's literally the same thing, but for my legs. These are probably my favorite piece I've made so far. There were definitely things on both the top and the pants that I could kind of nitpick at and be like, eh, I could have done that better, but I like these. These are my favorite pieces so far. Welcome to week 3 of my 2-week cosplay build. If I were to nail down my problem specifically, I would say that it's looking at a character design and thinking I can make the cosplay in 2 weeks. I think that's the source of our problems here. I didn't really work on Kishu during the week, and that's because things have been a little crazy. I got a car! Yay! A new Colleen Mobile. We are probably gonna have to modify some things with Kishu, and he isn't gonna be what I envisioned, but I'm gonna have something that works. So the one thing I absolutely have to finish is the wig. So I need to get this wig styled. I really can't be Kishu without the wig. So our boy Kishu, he has the short cropped hair in the back, bangs, and then he has his little pigtails. Now I knew this wig was already gonna take some time to style because of the short cropped hair in the back. So I just bought a longer wig, and I had to kind of cut down all the hair in the back of the wig. And then I also kind of separated out our little pigtails, got to working on those. He also has a little wrap around his pigtails that looks a lot like the arm and leg wraps. So I just did like a baby arm wrap. That's for the pigtail. The problem, you see, is that I have a tiny head and I don't have a lot of hair anymore. Back when I had a lot of hair, it would kind of make my head bigger and fill out the wig. So what I do is I tuck my ears under the wig caps when I wear a wig because the wigs are a little bit too big. Any of my cosplays you look at, since I cut my hair, the wig is actually going over my ear like this. And I was gonna do that again with Kishu until I realized that Kishu actually has giant ears. But you see, the problem's twofold. I have another problem with this wig. So there isn't a whole lot of hair in the pigtails. If you look at how much hair is between where the bangs end and where the ears start, it's really not much. Like what? This is like an inch worth of hair. So you can see here that I have kind of pulled hair from the side of the wig into our pigtail to fill it out. And that means that now our pigtail is kind of blocking off access to my ears, which would be fine, except Kishu has giant ears. So I came up with a solution, and it looks kind of silly from the back, but it works. But basically I'm taking our ears and I'm putting it through the pigtail like that, and that's how it has to work because I can't really make the pigtail any smaller and I still have to access my ear somehow. Ideally, I would have gotten some extra wefts of wig and I would have wefted those into the front so that there would have just been a whole lot of hair in the front to grab for the pigtails. That would have been ideal. I didn't do that and I don't have time now, so this will have to do. I'm calling Kishu done. He's good enough, okay? We're not going for amazing here, we're going for functional, and he is good enough. Now, I haven't made the shoes at all, but I did reach out to the other cosplayers in the collab and asked if it was okay if I had some shoes that weren't canon. I specifically asked if I could just wear these shoes. So, you know, heels for Kishu. I think he's gonna slay. Everyone was really supportive. They said it was fine if I just wanted to wear these shoes. So I have cut out making the canon shoes entirely. Now, I did have a variety of ideas for wheelchair decorations. I had a lot of really cool ideas and I'm scrapping all of those too. I did one wheelchair decoration. It's more of an attachment thing. Basically, I made like a little holster harness setup for my Sai props. Since I have started using my wheelchair, I have realized that having props that are meant to be held in your hands is kind of difficult when you need your hands to like walk. So we have a pair of wheelchair Sai holsters. I think those are pretty cool. Let's move on to the final reveal of this Kishu cosplay from Tokyo Mew Mew. Okay, so final thoughts on our little trash gremlin boy. Alien baddie boy. This is definitely a cosplay I don't think I would have really picked for myself, which isn't bad. I've done a lot of collabs with cosplays I wouldn't have picked for myself, and it's been a really good experience. It kind of expands not only my cosplay wardrobe, but also the sets of skills that I'm able to do. So it's not a bad thing. It's just really interesting, like looking in the mirror and seeing this boy, because I never would have thought that I would cosplay him. And here we are. It's a much different look than what I usually go for, but different is not always bad. About the actual craftsmanship, I definitely have regrets that I didn't give myself more time. If I am going to be a little bit kinder to myself, I really could have only started an extra week earlier. I joined the collab pretty late. And the thing is, my toxic trait is looking at a character and being like, I could do that in 2 weeks. And that's what happened. The craftsmanship isn't awful, Like, everything is properly lined, everything is properly hemmed. I think the wraps turned out really good. Like, the craftsmanship isn't awful, it's just I could have taken it a little bit further if I had more time. So will I learn not to make cosplays in only 2 weeks? Probably not. I will probably need a few more collabs of doing this before I finally learn. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!